guilt is all mine. Can't live without the trust from those you love. Sorry to everyone, but it's 8:40. What did your computer do, Ro? I've been sitting here for 10 minutes and I'm not waiting for anyone else. That's not butterfly soup. Let's get some music. Oh wait, I actually am able to see the chat on my computer screen now instead of looking down at my phone the whole time. I also used a different, calibration method, so hopefully my eyes won't be closed the whole time. If that happens again, I might need to start using a different face rig program. For those of you who weren't here last time, by which I mean Pastel, I just now loaded for you? I mean, it's just you. Oh wait, no, there's some other random people in chat who I don't know. No more scrying. I'm trying to do better with that. for those of you who weren't here last time, Butterfly Soup is a visual novel. The main character is named Dia. She's like a super weird, like socially anxious jock girl. Her best friends are named Noelle and Akarsha, and Noelle is sort of like a straight-laced nerd valedictorian, but she does have a good sense of humor. And Akarsha is 2016 meme culture boiled into a person, but she's pretty smart too. She causes problems on purpose. And then our love interest is a girl named Minso, who was a childhood friend of Dia's. And she moved away, and then we've just now sort of like re-met her. Like, she moved back to California, and she's like a punk girl who carries a knife and tries to fight anything that moves. But actually where I left off is I was about to start a flashback scene with Noelle. California isn't real, they made it up for Butterfly Soup. Oh, my window is still a bit too big. Problem something or other. What is this? Oh, she's got little stars in her hair. Can't read the test paper. Problem something or other. Oh shit, photography? What the hell does that mean? Yeah. -3. What the hell is going on? I don't know anything. I don't understand any of this. I'm going to fail. All my hard work up until now was for nothing. Wake up. What? Wake up. Huh? Oh. Oh, she was having a nightmare. There's little Dia. Dia looks very concerned. I had a nightmare. That was silly. It wasn't even real. Hi, Vesper! Sorry, feel better. She presents Noelle with a poorly wrapped, lumpy gift, almost as big as she is. Happy birthday! Despite Dia's best efforts, several spots of the gift aren't properly covered with the wrapping paper, and Noelle can clearly see what's inside. Worsty. I appreciate your kindness. May I open it here? Dia nods eagerly. Look, I'm nodding. Noelle unwraps the present and pretends to be shocked by its contents. It's a giant, bright green snake flesh. Aww, I like it. His name is Snakey. Look at how he's striped. Noelle looks. Indeed, he's striped. He's the youngest. He has two older brothers and a sister. You bought this for me? I won him from the hammer game at the fair. Hit the hammer really hard. I chose him because he reminds me of you. he reminds her of me how? I don't even like snakes, and stuffed animals are a useless waste of spit. Don't say that! Come on, Noelle! And against all logic, a lump forms in Noelle's throat, impossible to aww, you care about her. Noelle quickly stamps down all stupid emotions and focuses organizing her thoughts. Thank you. He is green, soft, and at least 5 feet long. Oh shit, that's massive. I will place him in my bedroom and preserve him in mint condition for as long as possible. She looks happy. A warm and fuzzy feeling swells in Noelle's chest. Aww. You're my favorite person. I think I may have developed some kind of attachment to you, too. We should go on vacation together someday when we grow up. It would be fun. That would be fun. I would accompany you with only mild complaining. Where? Maybe England? Can go to... Okay. Noelle watches Dia's face drop as she silently goes through the 5 stages of grief, remembering that most of the locations in Harry Potter aren't real. We can at least see Platform 9 and 3/4. They put a plaque of it at King's Cross. I've been there before, in real life. That's not a joke about being a wizard, I really have. What else do you want to see in England? All-you-can-eat buffet? They have those here, too. Do you even hate Wizards the Animal, Ro? Okay, congratulations on killing Jevil again. It's so simple to make you happy. If everyone thought like you, there would be no wars. Dia just doesn't appear to know how to respond to this, so she just looks away and smiles shyly. If we run out of things to do in England, we can always watch TV in our hotel room. No, you complain too much when things aren't scientifically correct. Oh, nerd. Like when radioactive things cause superpowers. You get so hung up on it, it's distracting. Distracting how? Distracting like... Noelle. Oh shit, this music. She's so mad. Shut up. Shut up. Shut up. This is not scientific. You can't do that. That's not how nuclear physics works. No, shut up. Don't say that about her. We can watch an educational... Oh shit, I accidentally... Hold on. Where's the button that lets me... Oh, there we go. We can watch an educational nature documentary then, like Planet Earth. I don't like the part where the baby elephant follows its mom's tracks the wrong way. We can skip the part where the baby elephant follows its mom's tracks the wrong way. Suddenly, Dia starts climbing off the playground structure. Just remembered. Actually, Dia had been preparing to say this for the past 15 minutes. Want you to meet someone. I think, yeah... they're like in elementary school here, I think. I made a new friend yesterday. Oh, I bet that's Minso. Min? Min? Is that a boy or a girl? Yeah, so this is elementary school because, Min moved away when they were like, 9 or something or like that. I don't remember. Not sure. Aww. How can you not be sure? Didn't you meet? It was hard to tell. You'll see what I mean. I will. When you become friends. Yeah, Minso is gender. Min is really nice. Gave me a seaweed cheat. I've never seen you this excited over someone before. They must be really something. Dia looks like she agrees. Time for violence. This must be him, her. Instead of introducing them, Dia's just happily standing there in silence. The other girl circles around Noelle's sides like, listen to this music. Her face darkens when she sees the snake plushie Dia gave her. Oh, she's jealous. So you're Dia's best friend. You giraffe. What? I'll fight you! Excuse me? There can only be one of us, so we have to duel. I'll beat you in hand-to-hand combat. What? No. Starting in 3, 2, 1. I already said no. Kill, kill, kill. What was that all about? What an idiot. What does DNC see in someone that dumb? I don't understand. I'm home. What did you get on the math test? An A minus. A minus? Why not an A? Noel's mom is cutting a column out of the Chinese newspaper. Look at this article. This boy was accepted into every single Ivy League college. Thank you. Why did I say thank you? Something's wrong with me. He lives in Pleasanton. If he can do it, why can't you? She's like 9. Putting this on your wall to inspire you. She gets up and tapes it in Noelle's bedroom next to a poem her dad printed out. There is no success without hardship. Hi. Can I go to the park with Dia this Saturday? What for? We're taking a walk around the lake. There's also a Petco nearby. She wants to look at the fish and hamsters. Will Dia still be your friend if you say no? Yes, but I want to. Then there's no point. Now that you've already established your friendship, you should be expending the minimum amount of energy to maintain it. That's not nice. Otherwise, you're just wasting your limited time. Fun is an illusion. Don't be controlled by your emotions. But I'm free that Saturday. Chinese school is on break. You can use it to study for your tests at school. I already studied for them. All of them? I finished reading all my textbooks already twice. Did you do all the practice problems? I did all the practice problems. Take that. There's nothing that could possibly be left for me to do. I'll buy next year's textbooks and you can get started on those then. Poor Noelle. I've got my game window sort of over to the side so that I can read chat, and all I can see at the top of the window is soup. That's the name of the game. Yeah, oh, it's so cute. Upset, Noelle curls up in bed, angrily hugging her giant snake plushie. Read next year's textbook. Damn, is it here already? The fox and the grapes. Oh, I've heard that one. Hungry fox saw a fine bunch of grapes hanging from a vine. He did his best to reach them by jumping as high as he could into the air. But it was all in vain, for they were just out of reach. So he gave up trying and walked away with an air of dignity and unconcern, remarking, I thought those grapes were ripe, but now I see they are quite sour. It's world's first crowdsourced gay man. Reading comprehension questions. 1. Why doesn't the fox eat the grapes? Couldn't reach them. Through the window, Noelle can hear someone whiffing a badminton racket outside. Oh, there's Junso. Sorry. It's okay. Sounds like they're playing badminton in the driveway without a net. They're probably in the dumb kids class. Why are you so enthusiastic about badminton? What does it was all in vain mean? It was useless. No! Oh my god, did you see that? They're both laughing. Badminton is pretty fun. Stupid hooligans wasting their time. I would play it sometimes in my like high school gym class. Having fun? Ha! I'm above such petty unnecessities. Noelle reads dictionaries for fun. They'll regret it when they're working at McDonald's someday. I hate sports anyway. I'm the real winner here. What's the message of the story? it's species. Oh, it's easy to despise what you can't have. White woman spotted. Noelle, you're up to bat. Noelle, yeah, so, Dia, went to join the baseball club at the school, and she's, like, super shy, so Noelle and Akasha went with her, and then, they also got forced to play baseball with the rest of the club. So that's what's happening now in this non-flashback scene. Noelle grudgingly steps up to the plate. I hate sports, why am I here? Akasha is pitching, uh-oh, that's not good for you! She raises her eyebrows at Noelle as she winds up. Wake up. What? Wake up, Frenchman. You're in a coma. I am not. You're trying to confuse me and failing. Akasha pitches the ball. Swing at the ball. I'm going to fail miserably. I didn't know I would be switching perspectives like this, actually. I thought Dio was just my main character. That's fun, though. I like all of them a lot. Through sheer luck, Noelle manages to hit the ball. It pops straight up. Noelle runs for first base with the agility of an old man with two broken legs. I got it. Krissa catches it in her mitt. The runner already on first base gives Noelle a strange look when she runs up. Noelle, you're out. Stop running, it's embarrassing. There she is, look how cool she is. I love Minso. What? Why? She caught it, genius. Oh, thank you for actually following me, Pastel. But, so? Why can't I run? How come the runner on first isn't out? The rules of this game are really incomprehensible. Are they? I don't know much about sports, and even I understand how baseball goes. It's okay, nice try. I don't need praise for failing, I'm not stupid. Noelle grabs a mitt and joins Dia and the others on the field. We're taking turns batting. Everyone who isn't a batter or runner is defending on the field. Are you bad at board games? How is that possible? Oh, do you just not get the rules? I know baseball, I played Wii Sports. I'm sorry for insulting your board game skills, Audrey. I feel so odd to be doing this. I keep half expecting someone to holler at me to get off. Gets shit? Everyone point and laugh. This motherfucker said shit. Typo in the Twitch chat. Feels so odd to be doing this. I keep half expecting someone to holler at me to get off. Suddenly, Dia swerves back to avoid a bee flying at her face. Did that bee just try to sting you? Come back here, you bitch bee coward. I'm gonna fuck you up. Min moves indignantly between Dia and the bee. She's trying to protect Dia from the bee. Min throws a punch at the offending bee. After silently watching a few fruitless swings, Dia takes off her hat and strikes the bee midair with the bill of her cap. Hell yeah. It falls to the ground dead. Min beams at her with pure adoration in her eyes. Chat, how's everything look? Do I have my eyes stuck closed again? Oh no, it seems that Wizard is awake for this stream. No, it doesn't. Yeah, I mean, it's not hard to watch Twitch streams on your phone. I've done it before. I don't pity you. When did you move back? About 2 weeks ago. Wow, if we had any classes together, we'd have crossed paths way sooner. Does Jinso go here now, too? No, he's at a different school. He goes to Niles. It's the browser on desktop mobile? What's wrong with you? That's an easier, less Asian school. Why would your parents put you in different schools? The browser won't let you what? Huh? They didn't. I originally went to there too, but I got expelled. You know I don't. The browser won't let you what? I mean, I know what's wrong with you. I just don't know what you're having issues with. Expelled? How was Florida? You're not going to ask about the expelled part? Horrible. They don't have boba places there. I had to drink milkshakes. Boba's not that good. It's like super weird texture-wise. Milkshakes are better. That's crazy. And everyone was white. Are white people... are white people that bad? Oh, I'm not reading that one out. That's not my place. They say go back to China and I'm not even Chinese. I had to get so good at beating people up. Hell yeah. Get their asses. What the heck? That sounds like a cartoon. I thought racism was over. Me too. But they showed us that cartoon every year in class where they time travel to end their segregation. What happened? Beats me. The next batter strikes out. Liz, who's acting as a catcher, returns the ball to Akasha. Akasha fumbles it and drops it on the mound. Everyone watches disapprovingly as she scrambles to pick it back up. That was an illusion. A trick of the light. No, we clearly saw you mess up. It's Dia's turn at bat now. Oh, she's gonna destroy it. Dia hits the pitch with a downright scary amount of force. The ball shoots over everyone's heads and lands in a tree in the distance, causing several startled crows to flap out. Yeah! Whose side are you on? We're supposed to be on defense. She's gay, it's okay, Noelle. Okay, but you have to admit that was sick. Nice one, Dia. Aw, she's so happy. It's Min's turn at the plate now. She immediately grabs the heaviest bat they have. Yeah, I'm gonna hit you with a baseball like that one guy who exploded the bird. Who was that pitcher? Y'all remember him? It was like Randy something. Minso, are you sure you want to use that? We have other bats that are closer to your... This one is fine. She hasn't even tried the other ones. But in general, people your size should use the 31-inch... No, I'm not some weakling! On the mound, Akasha paces back and forth as Min squares up in the batter's box. Are you trying to psych me out? I bet you can't eat 5 crayons. Oh yeah? I bet I can. No eating crayons while the club is in session, please. I bet I could eat 5 crayons. Would you pay me to eat crayons like that one wretched Tumblr user who I shall not name? Like, I'm pouring a pile of bird seed in front of a fake tunnel for Maldwin to run into. You would pay me to eat crayons for real? I'm gonna hold you to that. Actually, Noelle, how about you try pitching now? It's been a while since we switched. Me? Remember that time when I printed out and ate a piece of Mindy's art for like no reason, just because I said I would? You were going to pay me $10 in pennies. I left it in the bathroom. Noelle switches places with Akasha on the mound. She's not going to be able to- Bring it, you weak bitch! What are you insulting me for? We're on the same side now. Wait, are the- The pitcher and the batter aren't on the same side. No, they're- What? No- Oh, they- No, we're not. What the heck are you talking about? I was so confused for a sec, I forgot she doesn't know shit about sports. Don't baseball pitchers pitch to their own team? No? Everyone is shooting Noel appalled looks. No, you pitch against the enemy. It's the pitcher's goal not to let the batter get on base. Oh, I see. So that's why they pitch at such high velocity. So it's harder for the batter to hit a touchdown. Yeah, go sports. Noel, have you ever watched a baseball game before? Can you even name a single baseball team? Let's go Mets, baby. Love the Mets. Oh, it's not an option. I don't think any of these are baseball teams. I'm gonna choose this one. The A's? Oh, Crystal looks immensely relieved. Okay, wait, so that is a baseball team. I chose that one because it sounded the most like a baseball team, but I didn't think there were any right answers. Bravo, if you failed that, I probably would have started crying. Min squares up in the batter's box. Throw the ball. Noel throws the ball with all her might. It plops back down into the grass, not even halfway to Min. The hell was that? That throw was so soft. Nobody ordered ice cream, Noel. Get it together. All right, I get it. I guess we'll count that as a ball. What? You didn't throw it through the strike zone. If you miss, it's a ball. I mean, it is a ball, physically. If you throw four balls before the batter strikes out, the batter goes to first base for free. Where's the strike zone exactly? My birthday's in so long. That's months and months and months away. Don't make me wait that long. If you're gonna make me fan art, you have to give it to me now. I'm not that patient. Where's the strike zone exactly? You can do it whenever you like, but... I forgot what I was gonna say. Going to... Wait, what do you mean, make him real? Like, cardboard? Is that what you meant? Oh, what? I don't want that. Don't do that. I'll kill you. Like a plush? Aww. Okay, if you want to do that, take as long as you need. I thought you just meant, like, you were gonna draw him. That's so sweet. Min looks like she's about to beat me to death. It starts at the midpoint between the top of the batter's shoulders and the top of their pants. The bottom... Yeah. The bottom is a line at the hollow beneath the kneecap. Sort of forgot how to read on that one. What happens if you're wearing a skirt? Does it default to the nearest pair of pants you own? You have to be wearing proper uniform pants to play official games. There's rules about that. If we want to throw the game, but in a subtle way, all we have to do is pull our pants up really high. Like, up to our armpits. That's not subtle at all. It is if it's under the shirt. Oh, I forgot there was, like, other characters. Assuming we play this the regular way, don't short people just naturally have smaller batting zones? Since their bodies are smaller? Yeah, it takes more precision to strike them out. By the way, measurements are based on the batter's stance, not while they're standing straight up. Knowing that, can't we just reduce the batting zone's volume to zero by squatting down? Okay, short people don't exist. Aren't you like 5'2"? That way, any pitch they throw becomes a ball. That's cheating. I don't know if there's a rule against that, but if you do anything too weird, it'd be considered poor sportsmanship. I'm not 5'2", I'm 5'4". If it feels like the other people aren't playing fair, it won't be fun anymore. It's still 2 inches on you. The umpire will probably stop you too. It's 5'4", and then I have extra height from the cat ears and the hat. Whenever something's not explicitly outlined in the rules, it's his call. Can't believe I'm actually learning things about baseball. Okay, are we done explaining now? Can we play baseball? Yeah. It's part of my full wizarding height. Sure, I think we covered all the bases. Oh my god. Don't laugh. Just stare at her. That was horrible. Crystal looks disappointed by Noelle's cold reception to her joke. I love just like staring at people blankly when they tell bad jokes. It's always funny. My joke was a swing and a miss. I better pitch the ball before she says more. I wasn't gonna say sans, but I guess you did it for me. Throw the ball. Noelle hurls the ball with all might. It plops down in the grass in the exact same spot as last time. Dia raises her hand and looks at Chris expectantly, like she's waiting to be called on. Yes? You can just talk. You don't have to do that. Noelle doesn't have enough upper body strength to throw it that far. That's a problem. No matter what position she plays, she's gonna have to throw it that far at some point. Well, good thing I'm not joining this stupid club, then. Problem solved. Alright, whatever. I'll pitch for now. Noelle hands the ball over to Krissa and joins Akersha and Dia back on the field. As Noelle jogs up to him, Akersha plucks a dandelion from the grass and presents it to her. Yeah, Noelle hates sports. Oh, sports? If you were a flower, you'd be a dandelion. This is literally a weed. Is that a weed? I'm calling the police. Akersha tries to blow the dandelion seeds into Noelle's eyes. Stop that. Min smacks Chris's pitch into the ground and takes off running. I like how you just, like, said something that was, that, like, just happened in the game as if it's, like, an opinion or an observation and not just, like, something you saw happen. Dia tears after it with the look of a dog chasing a squirrel. She scoops it up and throws it to Akersha, who's manning first base now. I got it! I got it! Terrible? Are you calling Noelle terrible, or are you saying I'm terrible for publicly ridiculing you on my stream? Akersha tries to catch it, but ends up knocking the ball away with the tip of her glove. Huh? Me? Me? You really think I'm terrible? You would say that to me in my own home? You're so mean to me. Akersha, you need to work on your catches. Huh? Why? You dropped the ball. What? That wasn't me. That was totally you. Everyone saw. Incredible. That must be my look-like from another dimension. You briefly blimped a parallel universe when Akersha didn't catch the ball. This is just like Zero Escape, but now you've crossed back over to the reality where I did catch it. That explains the memory discrepancy. It's the only logical explanation. Or you messed up and just won't admit it. Min manages to round the bases and score thanks to Akersha's mistake. Akersha, you're up to bat. This is fun. I'm ready. Akersha twirls the bat behind her back, squats down for no reason, and hops up several times like a frog before springing back up into a dramatic pose. Is she going to do that every single time she goes up to bat? Knowing her, yes. My signature.
Zero Escape Baseball AU.
What? You don't need a signature. Watch out! Huh? Karsha batted a ball straight at Noelle. Can I what? Do you want to see Wizard full body? I can. Please send more comprehensible messages. I can read. I don't know what you're talking about. Like, just because I'm not reading all your messages out loud doesn't mean I'm not seeing them. Unless you're saying something on Discord, in which case I'm not reading it. Noelle flails her arm in a panicked attempt to catch the ball. She misses it. Krissa does nothing. She's still sulking because Noelle didn't laugh at her joke. Yeah, I saw that message. I... Oh wait, I forgot I was supposed to be reading the dialogue. You're distracting me. See, this is why I can't read every message. I mean, I can read them all. I just mean I can't respond to them all. Oops. Are you calling me a stupid people or Ro? Because I'm not a stupid people. That was a ghost. It wasn't a ghost. The axe cut through it like a baseball bat through a ghost. Y'all remember that one? It's Min's turn to pitch now. You are stupid people. It's okay. We still love you. Krissa hands the ball over to her and heads over to the plate to bat. Maybe I'll start reading all the narration in like a baseball announcer voice. Baseball bat through a ghost? I'm not talking about your video games. That's something that they say in the Adventure Zone. The fielders are all backing up. Krissa is even taller than Dia, so she looks like she could hit it pretty far. What the fuck is wrong with you? What the fuck is wrong with you? Why does her shirt say that? That's so funny. Min clutches the ball in a claw-like grip. She brings her arm back and then forward, hard over the top, and let's go. The ball approaches the plate. It does a little hop, like a hiccup. What? How? Krissa looks weirded out. She doesn't swing. I would wear a shirt that says, "What the fuck is wrong with you?" The flutter is just enough to throw Liz off. The ball glances off the side of her glove and bounces off her kneecap. Oh, wait! She threw one of the fancy she threw one of the fancy pitches from, last time when, fucking, what was it? Oh yeah, in one of the like flashback scenes, Min and Dia went to a baseball game together, and like her dad was telling them about this like fancy type of pitch where it's like, basically if a pitcher can like, was it called the knuckleball? It was something like that. It was like a special pitch where it's like, if a pitcher can throw that pitch, they basically, like, go in a pair with the catcher, like, who has to learn to catch that specific type of pitch. Yeah, she did it to impress Dia. Because she wants to, like, GoPro with baseball and have them be, like, a special pitcher-catcher pair. And if she can throw the special pitch and if Dia can catch it, then it's, like, you know, they have to be traded together. What the? It's kind of creepy, isn't it? Seeing the ball coming at you without spinning. Yeah, it was like just floating at me. I couldn't tell the difference. It looked normal to me. Liz returns the ball to Min. Min clutches it in the same messed up looking grip, rears up, and lets another pitch go. Krissa misses it by a foot. It's a pitch you couldn't hit with a tennis racket. Liz has to twist into a weird angle to stop the ball in the dirt. You're normal? Are you? Why are you saying that? A knuckleball, huh? Oh, it is called a knuckleball. Sorry for not believing you. What's that? It's a rare pitch thrown with nearly no spin, so its path is unpredictable. Oh, I get it. You're making this up as an excuse for why you missed. Row is not normal. I'm not making it up. It operates on the same principle as a float serve in volleyball. I don't know what that means either. Or a knuckleball in soccer, if you know that. No, I don't know either of those. Did you log on to your computer finally? Your Nemo? You're trying so hard. Why are you saying you're normal? What did you do? You're still on mobile? Well, then you're not normal. Come back to me when you're normal. Don't leave, though. Okay, so when you pitch a ball normally, it spins like crazy, somewhere around 10 times on the way to the plate. Spin is what gives a ball stability as it moves. If you can learn to throw a ball with minimal spin, its instability will give it an unpredictable trajectory. I'm Nemo. I'm the fucking devil. It starts behaving like a chaotic system, like the weather. And that's great, because a lot of sports mastery is just recognizing situations. You aren't strong enough to handle my strongest potions. Everyone says keep your eye on the ball, but it's actually impossible to do that due to the limitations of human reaction. What good hitters actually do is anticipate the ball's flight paths based on cues they recognize from being in similar situations before in the past. This is so cool. In other words, they don't see the ball, they just guess its trajectory. Oh, but they can't do that against a knuckleball. Whoa. That's right, a knuckler's trajectory is drastically different each time it's pitched. So no matter how good you are, there's no way to reliably hit it. I'm gonna start sharing baseball fun facts with people like Zero Escape characters with the Titanic facts. Just like in the middle of conversation for no reason. Thrown correctly, it moves so erratically that it's impossible to hit except through sheer luck. I still can't tell if you're making all this up as an excuse for why you suck. No, it's real. But you couldn't catch it, so it's also a convenient excuse to you. And if it is real, then why doesn't everyone use it? It sounds practically game-breaking. Well, for one, knuckleball is one of the hardest pitches to throw in baseball, if not the hardest. Put a little too much spin on the ball or throw it just a little too fast, you're basically serving up a meaty practice pitch that'll get hit out of the park. And even at its best, a knuckler is a double-edged sword. Batters can't hit it, but that also means pitchers can't control it, and catchers can't catch it. When thrown right, even Min has no idea where it's going. They say throwing a knuckleball for a strike is like throwing a butterfly into a mailbox across the street. It's like throwing a hot dog down a hallway. Even in the big leagues, catchers hate it. And if I let it get past me, it could lead to the batter or a runner on the base advancing. With a I hate words. With a knuckleballer pitching, the catcher has to focus so hard on stopping it that the runners on the base will have an easier time stealing. It's a big pain. So basically, it's hard to throw right, it's hard to control even when you do throw it right, and it's punishing if you miss. Pretty much, no one trusts it. Knuckleball is the pitch of someone with nothing left to lose. And that's us. We can try things that no coach in their right mind would ever risk, because no one expects anything from us. So we might as well take advantage of that, right? Even if we don't win a single game, at least we'll have fun. Oh shit, I just noticed that their team name is Monarchs. I never, like, actually read the jersey. Shut up, nerd. Fun, what kind of nonsense is this? Krissa strikes out. The ball ricochets off Liz's mitt and catches her bare hand, striking her thumb at a painful-looking angle. Ow! Min, you broke her thumb! Okay, time out. That looked pretty painful. I just lost the game! Liz's thumb has turned a swollen purple. Are you okay? Now, Liv. Min, is this all you know how to throw?
I can throw fastballs too, but they're not that fast. So knuckleball is kind of my specialty.
I used to watch videotapes of Tim Wakefield pitching on TV over and over again and copied that.
It's the only pitch I really practiced.
That's so smart, honing all your skill on an off-speed pitch, knowing that you don't have the muscle to throw fast. Did your coach suggest it?
No, I didn't have one. No one taught me anything, I taught myself.
Huh? Then what made you decide to specialize as a knuckler?
I chose it because, it's hard to catch. She chose it because she's gay.
So Dia has to be the one to catch it, since it'll hurt everyone else.
What kind of reason is that?
She's so stupid, she unknowingly ended up doing something smart. I have to approve the term. Ad permitted term gay ass. So cool. Thank you, Harley.
Since she's so stupid, she unknowingly ended up doing something smart.
Min, what do you mean by Dia having to catch it? Oh my god, I just got, like, lightheaded for no reason.
Dia's immune to it because she's special.
Poisons don't hurt me. I'm pretty sure that's not how it works. Dia has been standing by, hopefully, for 5 minutes now, looking like she wants to say something.
Forlay, my friend, forlay.
Dia, would you like to try catching in my place? Oh, she's so excited. Dia nods furiously.
Then that settles it. Let's switch.
Once Dia is strapped on all the gear, Min throws it again.
Dia caught it.
What?
She sounds like Fox falling off the stage in Super Smash Bros. Melee. I don't know what that sounds like. I'm not a gamer.
I knew it. Krissa was making it up. I'm never believing your lies again.
We weren't lying.
Dia just caught it again.
Yeah, you would understand. Gamer. Oh, look at her! Look at her.
See? Dia's amazing!
Okay, that has to be a fluke. Calm down.
You're the one who needs to calm down.
They've managed to relieve another hitter together. Akarsha's up next.
Smash player, derogatory.
On her way to the plate, she tries to do the splits, flails, and sheepishly... sheepishly crawls back to her feet. Too many S's in that word. That was my plan all along. I'm playing a four-dimensional chess.
God, I can't stand her.
I want to push her off a cliff. But a shallow one, so she doesn't get hurt just to scare her. I hope Noelle and Akarsha have, like, a rivals to lovers arc. Because the way they interact is so funny.
Min winds up and throws another knuckler. It veers wildly up to the sky. Without hesitation, Dia rises out of her crouch and gloves it.
What? That would have been a ball, but still.
Is it really that surprising? Dia's always been good at sports.
I'd be more shocked if she failed.
No, but you don't understand. This goes beyond being good at sports. It's literally impossible.
Yes! Kid genius baseball supreme!
Karsha swings and misses for a third time. She's struck out.
That was performance art. You can't make these excuses every time you mess up.
Lesbians are literally just better at baseball.
Once Dia and Min have relieved the entire roster, Liz claps her hands together to get their attention.
All right, everyone, let's end the meeting for today.
What, already?
Yeah, it's been like 2 hours.
Huh? Aw, Noelle, were you having fun? They say time flies when you're having fun. But I wasn't having fun. I must have been so miserable that my mind wiped parts of my memory out. Uh-huh, yeah, right. Let's head back inside. Dia, I'll race you! I was on, like, a Parks and Rec baseball team once, in my youth, but it sucked because they always put me in the outfield, and it's like, no child can hit a baseball out that far, so I just kind of stood there the whole time. So I only did it for, like, one season. D and Min tear off at top speed. After a beat, the others begin heading uphill as well at a deliberately more reasonable pace. I haven't seen Dia this happy since the time the vending machine malfunctioned and gave her two Kit Kat bars instead of one. Noelle suddenly tries to regulate her breathing rate so no one knows she's getting winded walking uphill. Not anymore, though. Can I take your order, please, sir? Hey, Noelle. Thanks for putting up with us today. Lucky is basically a baseball, if you think about it. Sorry he sort of forced you to play. It wasn't the worst. I may find it in me to forgive you someday. Yeah, you did good. I did terrible. Okay, you did terrible. But you tried your best, and that's what matters. It's not like everyone can be Dia. So don't worry so much, and just have fun. Ball base? How'd that happen? It's not a competition. I mean, it kind of literally is a competition. Right. Because it pats Noelle on the head. Oh. Don't touch me. We really appreciate you pitching in. Come on, are they gonna do that every time? Yuck. Noelle tries to escape. She takes one step, slips on the muddy grass, and falls on her butt. Noelle! What are you doing, Noelle? Trying to win America's Funniest Home Video? Krista, you pull her up. My hands are full. No! Noelle scrambles to her feet and follows the others up the bank as quickly as she can. Not very quick. Hey, wait! Noelle! They're being nice to me to trick me into joining the club. I won't fall for it. Unlike some people, I have control over my emotions. I'll just ignore her. Fuck! What was that? Min is picking herself off the ground. There's a Min-shaped dust imprint on the door. Girl, are you okay? The door was locked. You probably should have checked before ramming straight into it. Don't tell me what to do. Looks like we'll have to wait for Krista and Liz to unlock it. Min pulls a lighter out of her pocket and lights a cigarette. Okay. Are you serious? I bet she's gonna take, like, one puff of it and be like, oh shit, that's gross. That's illegal. What the goddamn hell is your damage? I can't do anything without you calling it illegal. Because it is illegal. Even if it wasn't, what kind of idiot are you? Didn't you learn about the health effects of tobacco in school? You know she wasn't paying attention in school, Noelle. It's just a bunch of statistics. Plenty of people smoke and don't die. What, you think you're better than the laws of probability? Yeah, I am. I think she is too. She's built different. Go ahead and remove yourself from the gene pool then. I don't care. Hey, Min, can I try smoking it? What? Have you lost your mind? Come on, aren't you curious? It's not like I'll get addicted from one smoke. Min is immune to poisons. Min holds a cigarette out for Akasha. Here. Don't mind if I do. No! Oh! Noelle bats the cigarette out of Akasha's hands. It lands- Uh-oh. Noelle, you're an arsonist! It lands on some dried pine needles and bursts into flames. Look what you've done! Frenchman, what have you done? Shut up! Smokey the Bear is crying right now. Only you can prevent forest fires! Well, shit. What do we do now? Pee on it. It's not a jellyfish. Are you stupid? Stop, drop, and roll. You don't do that unless you're already on fire. Head on. Apply directly to the forehead. This isn't helping. Silence falls over the group as they hear approaching footsteps on the other side of the wood divider. Sounds like Krista and Liz are slowly getting closer to the locker room. Hey, what are you guys screaming about? Nothing's wrong. Don't come in here. Is everything okay? Everything is fine. Where's the nearest fire extinguisher? The footsteps pause for a brief stunned moment before resuming with dramatically increased speed. I mean, you can just step on it. It's like a small fire, probably. You could just, like, put it out with your boot. Crap, we need to fix this. Don't any of you have, like, a fucking water bottle? You were just playing sports. We should smother it. Someone use their jacket. That's also, I was thinking of that as well. What if the jacket gets burnt? Well, that would look sick. I mean, I bet Min would like that if her jacket got, like, cool and tattered, distressed, a burnt look, right? This is my favorite jacket, man. And rightfully so, it's a very cool jacket. Same. Okay, who likes her jacket the least? Me. Dia, you're so noble. Min watches with extreme interest as Dia strips off her hoodie, but looks incredibly disappointed when she sees Dia's wearing a shirt underneath. Oh man, I'm like... Hold on, one sec. Harsha throws the jacket over the fire and stomps on it. Okay, I think we extinguished it. Teamwork. Dia picks her jacket up and shakes it out. Other than mud prints from Akarsha's flip-flops, it looks no worse for wear. I can't believe Frenchman snapped and tried to commit arson. That's what I said. That's not what happened. Can I Oh yeah, I can. Check this shit out. Did that work? I don't know if I hit the hotkey. Hold on. There we go. Why do you want me to be sad? Hey, why do you want me to be sad? You hate me? You want to see me frowning? Look what you've done. You made me sad. Chris and Liz are here. What's that? A burnt smell? Who did it? It was Jerry. We're inventing a person now? Who the hell is Jerry? He's a guy, black hair. Right, we all saw him. He did it. Oh my god, you even got Noelle lying. Dia nods helpfully. They're about to snap. What a day. Somehow ended up playing baseball, got patted by some random upperclassmen, and was interrogated over arson. Yay! Lying! They questioned us all separately on our account, and our accounts of Jerry fell apart. In the end, they made us do push-ups as punishment. Oh, I'm sure that sucked for you, girl. I'm exhausted. I'm home. What did you get on the math test? An A. An A? Why not an A+? Noelle's mom is cutting a column out of the Chinese newspaper. Look at this article. A CEO sold his company for over $1 billion and donated $200 million to UC Berkeley. There's a building at Berkeley named after him now. He's American-born Chinese, just like you. If he can do it, why can't you? I'm putting this on your wall to inspire you. She gets up and tapes it in Noelle's bedroom next to the shelf, gleaming with Noelle's math competition trophies. She still has the snake! Yes! Check your computer. Dude, what the hell did I miss in elementary school? According to Min, basically she's your childhood arch nemesis.
and Dia's ex. Oh, she's got a little piano icon. The arch nemesis part is accurate, but she's not Dia's ex. That's ridiculous. Okay, she didn't use those exact words, but pretty much. That's impossible. Noelle, come on. So? What do you mean, so? Can't believe you have an arch nemesis. I didn't even know people had those in real life. Please, for the love of God, teach her what gay people are. How is this gonna work? I don't understand what you're asking. Please reword the question. What are you gonna do about Min? Nothing. She doesn't pose me any threat. Dia made her promise not to hurt me before, so she's strictly limited to insulting and threatening me. All bark and no bite, so to speak. I'm probably actually the safest person in school as the only one with this kind of immunity. True. I'll just try my best to avoid her. What? She's friends with both Dia and me now. You gotta figure out how to deal with her sooner and later. No, I don't. My strategy worked flawlessly all the way through elementary school. There's no reason to change it now. Your strategy? Maybe if I ignore the problem, it'll go away strategy? I don't really have a choice. You don't understand how stupid she really is. She's not just pretending to be dumb like you. She's dumb for real. Once she carved her name into a desk and couldn't figure out how they caught her. Oh. Wait, hold up. Wait, I got it. Join the baseball club. Why? How does that solve anything? If you get buff, you can beat her up. It doesn't. Oh, or that. But trust me, it always works in the movies. Yeah, through the power of sports, anything is possible. Whenever two characters hate each other, if they end up in a situation where they're forced to work together, they come out of it as BFFs. More realistically, they'd go from enemies to worse enemies. No, I'm calling it right now. We're going to miraculously set our differences aside and work as a team. Also, we win by one. Come on, Frenchman. One of us. One of us. Oh, no. Yes. Leave the Eiffel Tower behind. Stop telling everyone I live inside the Eiffel Tower. Make your dreams into a reality. This isn't my dream. Then what is? Doesn't it bother you that everyone else our age gets to have fun? Like, bro, where's my complicated relationship drama? Where's my reckless teen adventures? Don't you feel like you're missing out, sitting at home alone all the time? No, because it'll pay off in the future. But your youth is irreplaceable. Noelle was invited to the baseball club group chat. I'll just take a quick look and then quit. That's it. Yay! Noelle has entered the chat room. Oh, look at her. I know we've seen it before, but look at her icon. I saw a golden retriever puppy today. She's so excited. Hello? What the fuck? Oh, look at her icon. You think she got her brother to take that picture for her? Why are you here? What are you gonna do? Use a parabola to calculate how to throw the ball? Parabola? Shut the fuck out. You long green bean. Green bean? Shut the fuck out. You stupid overachieving Asian fob loser stereotype. That's the model from the website she got the shirt from? Oh, that makes sense. Overachieving. Oh, she's that kind of person who corrects typos. I used to be that kind of person when I was younger. big words for someone who'll be attending community college and working at McDonald's. Noelle hates the working class. Guys, come on. Don't be like this. Become BFFs. Look how much you have in common. Asian, full of anger, and you both like Dia. Let's all sing the Barney song. I love you. I love you. You love me. We're a happy family. Min has changed the group chat name to Fuck You Noelle. Who gave her the power to do that? I don't like this group chat name. Suck it. Noelle changed the group chat name to Baseball Club. Min changed the group chat name to Fuck You Noelle. Stop this. Noelle changed the group chat name to Baseball Club. Min changed the group chat name to Fuck You Noelle. Guys. Guys, this is so immature. How about a compromise? Huh? What sort of compromise? Change the group chat name to Baseball Club. Thank you. What the fuck? How is this a compromise? I didn't get anything. Yeah, we said may change your name to Noelle Fucker 69. Nice. Oh, it's a high five emoji? Yes! I take it back. This is unacceptable. Change it back. Humankind cannot gain anything without first giving something in return. To obtain something of equal value must be lost. That is alchemy's first law of equivalent exchange. In those days, we really believed that to be the world's one and only truth. I hate you. Starts crying. I'm crying. You made me cry. Yeah, could you not tell from the everything about her that she's like an anime fan? If you don't change it, I'm not going to be your partner for school projects anymore. Changed it back to Yaoi-seme. Darn. It was good while it lasted. I wonder if there's anything else I have to figure out about baseball that no one else has yet. Like other strategies that'd make us there's soup everywhere. Other strategies that'd make us statistically more likely to win. I think there's another L in statistically. You're a hypocrite. You spelled it wrong. Or weird other loopholes. I'm warm. Streaming is making me sweaty. There's soup everywhere. Huh? I wasn't saying that you spelled soup wrong. Soap? I was making fun of Noelle. I wasn't clowning on you. I thought you said soup on purpose. Can we release multiple balls in the air to confuse our opponents? I think that would just confuse us too. What about advantages for batting? Come on. What the fuck's a yaoi paddle? Google it. In any case, they have rules about what kind of bats you can use. Dude, this just gave me a great idea. I'm Albert Einstein. Was that your idea? No, that's not it. It was my reward for being a genius. I think Akarsha read Homestuck and Kin's Dave. Sorry for saying that. What if you break a bat in half and dual wield one half in each hand? I don't think there would be any advantage doing this. We gotta try it to know for sure. For science. There's rules about damaged bats.
I'm always right, Harley. If they break, they're removed from play without penalty. No! My plan is crumbling to pieces. Your plan was in pieces from the start. Rude. My backup plan is we could secretly replace Adia's bones with synthetic ones. I don't like this plan. What about nanomachines? I don't want nanomachines. Nanomachines are not even at the level where we can use them yet. It's still a theoretical field. What? I thought they made nanocars already. With wheels and everything. Just a moment, I'm Googling it. Oh, what? Huh? What did I click on? I guess I'll save. Don't know how I got to the save screen. I don't want nanocars. The Wikipedia page says nanocars don't even have motors. They just have four wheels attached to an empty frame. They don't do anything. Oh shit, there's like molecules. Oh my god, wait! It's a car made out of molecules! I mean, I guess all cars are made out of... I'm so fucking stupid. I like these little hexagon ball wheels, though. Why the hell did they even create them? I don't know. They would just be floating pointlessly around inside Dia. For our purposes, gene therapy would be more practical. I'm putting your ass in the CRISPR. I just mean a car out of molecules. The technology is already used to treat muscle wasting disorders. We could use it to change Dia's gene expression and increase the production of proteins to make her stronger. It would be totally undetectable by drug tests. So cool. Oh my fucking god. I don't want gene therapy. It'd be like doping, but with your genes. Gene doping. Has anyone done this yet? I wouldn't know. I'm looking it up, and dude, no one's ever done it. There aren't any regulations on it yet. The future is now. I bet all the baseball people don't even know what it is. You could be a gene doping pioneer. You haven't even been here 10 minutes and you're already destroying baseball. I don't think this is the way we're supposed to do it. Guys. Oh my god. I looked up Cyborg on Wikipedia and I found she's gonna send a picture of Noelle. There's a man. Never mind. I thought she was making a joke. Did she make a joke earlier? Oh yeah, there was a joke earlier about she like held a magnet up to Noelle's head and she's like, it's disrupting your circuits. Oh, get a load of this guy. It looks like a fucking My Hero Academia character. What the hell? Since 2004, British artist Neil Harbison has a cyborg antenna implanted in his head that allows him to extend his perception of colors beyond the human visuals. Oh my god, this man can see shrimp colors. Huh? Elmo. His antenna was included within his 2004 passport photograph, which has been claimed to confirm his cyborg status. This is great. The claim to confirm his cyborg status makes him sound so desperate. Right? Plus the design is ridiculously unfashionable. I wouldn't take you for the type to care about fashion, Noelle. You normally expect cyborgs to look cool and futuristic. But instead... Oh, that's how you know she's gay. It's even better if you remember this is from 2004. Oh my fucking god, the black and white makes you think this is from the Great Depression or something, but it's just some weirdo with a lame haircut. He looks like he's planning to dangle a carrot on a string from the front. Like a donkey. Shut up, I'm losing it. It's only been 4 years. I forgot this game took place in 2008. Not only is he still alive, but his current appearance is probably relatively unchanged. This man is still out there existing in the same world we do, looking like this as we speak. good. Whenever you're feeling down about your looks, it takes place in 2008. Yeah. Remember. Every time they just send the picture, it's really good. Uh-oh. Knock before you enter. Why are you smiling? Are you talking to a boy? No boyfriend until college. Noelle almost falls out of her chair in shock. I didn't hear her come in. Noelle switches to a more academic tab she kept open, but not before her mom sees. You always change the screen when I come in. What are you hiding? Her mom grabs the mouse and clicks on the incriminating tab. You're wasting time. Do your homework. Her mother scans the names on the screen and jabs a finger at Albert Einstein. Who's that? That's Akarsha. She's the other smart girl in my grade. The one who almost beat you on the midterm? Yes. Don't forget that everyone is your competition. She's tricking you into thinking she doesn't study when really she does. Every minute you spend doing useless things is the minute she's beating you. She's not tricking me. We're friends. Friends, don't be naive. When she gets into MIT and you don't, do you think she'll care? If you were really in trouble, would she do anything to help you? I mean, yes, she pulled the fire alarm for us earlier. Of course not. When it comes down to it, nobody will look out for you. The only people you can really trust are your family. You don't know anything. Yes, get her ass! Don't talk about my friends like they mean nothing. Do you know anything about me? What's my worst fear? What's my favorite documentary series? You would know these things if you had any care for me beyond how good I make you look to our relatives. Yes! Oh no, I hope that doesn't have consequences for her. You ungrateful child. The whole reason we came to America is so you could live a better life. We made so many sacrifices for you. How dare you say we don't care about you? You've been spoiled rotten. You have an attitude problem. Kids these days. When your dad comes home, we're going to have a long talk about this. Noelle's mom closes the tab. She hovers over her shoulder for a few minutes to verify that Noelle is doing her work. Don't you have anything better to do? Oh, that's right, you don't. Because you have no friends or hobbies and live vicariously through me. Still looking sour, her mom finally leaves. Poor Noelle. Upset, Noelle curls up in bed, angrily hugging her giant snake plushie. Aw, she's so excited. Yuck, why'd you come back? Are you still deciding whether to join or something? No, I have decided. I'm in. Yes! Oh shit! Oh, we're randomizing our protagonist! It's Akarsha's turn! Yes! Hey, I'm here! Hello, Dia, homie! Yay, Spite! Dia's crawling on her hands and knees in the bushes. You got a worm? What are you doing? Caught him. Oh my god, she has a worm. Dia emerges from the brush with a caterpillar in her hands. It's fat and striped. Yes! Ew! Dia turns to face her. I need to stretch. How's everything look on your end? I can't see past my game window. Am I still calibrated? Got my eyes closed? It's fat and stupid. It is. I forgot she's deaf in one ear. Because she's deaf in one ear, when she stands up straight, she actually faces slightly to the right. Don't be rude. We should give him a name. Didn't even need to think. Zeroed in! Miles Tails Edgeworth. What kind of a name is that? It's a character from the Ace Attorney games. It's hella gay, you should play it! You say that like I'd be interested just because it's gay. You're not? Good gay stuff is hard to come by. Yeah, that's his name. Miles Tails Edgeworth. Tia scrutinizes Miles Tails Edgeworth as he inches across her palm. You're so invested in these kinds of things, video games and stuff. They're a form of escapism. I need obsessions to distract me from the crushing emptiness and hopelessness of life. Just kidding. Dia scoops the caterpillar into her other hand. Did you hear the news? Obama won. Yes, we can. Oh, 2008. Yeah, but they outlawed gay marriage. They did? Prop 8 passed. I thought we were better than that. You shouldn't be surprised. There were a lot of yellow-wearing guys. Don't even have to ask my parents what they voted, I know. But the thing is, it used to be legal. We used to be better. It's not just that the world sucks. The world sucks and it's getting worse. Obama, though. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Miles Tails Edgeworth is crawling up Dia's arm now. Gross. That's so shallow. He has a good heart. Don't black and yellow stripes normally mean it's poisonous? No, that means it's like a, I think that's a tiger swallowtail. No. I know the yellow and black and white striped ones. Pastel, I bet you know this. Is that the monarch or the tiger swallowtail caterpillar? Caterpillars are only poisonous if you eat that. Yeah, it wasn't a yes or no question. It was an either or. Which one is it? Those are different butterflies. Love you. Is it a monarch or a tiger swallowtail? Yeah, it's one of them for sure. Resident bug expert has fucking failed me. Not dangerous if you're nice. There are some... Oh, it's a monarch? Hell yeah, I know everything. There are some caterpillars that are, poisonous to touch. I guess that would be venomous. Tia carefully returns the caterpillar to a tree branch. Ready to go? Tia nods. Akasha. Yeah? Never mind. What the? We went ahead and got changed. It feels like we're a real team now wearing the same. We're gonna get like baseball uniform sprites. Oh, eh. I missed dialogue. She just said there's time. I read it. Oh god. Let's talk to Noelle. Aw, she looks so cute! Noelle is solving a professor's cube. Unlike a regular Rubik's cube, it's 5x5x5 instead of 3x3x3. That sounds fun. Dia's face lights up when she spots it. I solved one side for you already. Took me 2 hours. Aww. Dia proudly points to the cube. Indeed, one face is solid red. I see. I'm pretty sure that doesn't help at all. Sure enough, Noelle completely obliterates Dia's work in order to solve the cube correctly. Wow, you make it look so easy. In high school, in like one of my English classes, when we were doing like an icebreaker, it was like, you know, share a fun fact about yourself or whatever. One guy was like, I can solve a Rubik's cube in under a minute or something like that. And he had a Rubik's cube in his bag, so we timed him and he could. It was fucked up. Like, I forget the time he said, but it was, like, really fast. Did I help? Of course, I appreciate it. Aww. Taslin moment? I don't know what that means. Dia's on the bench, resting out. Aww. She must be pretty bent over to rest her head on Min's shoulder. They're a tuber that cubes. I think it can digging in the ground for tubers. The little cube bitches? Do you mean a fucking Rubik's cube, you clown? Remember those cube games? They had, like, a little stick figure guy inside them, and when you turned them around, the guy would, like, fall, and you could connect them to each other. What were those called? She's showing Min a picture of a seagull on her cell phone. You're getting distracted by a wizard? How? Too much stimuli on screen for you. Oh, good God. She's showing Amin a picture of a seagull on her phone. One side of the photo is blurry from Dia's thumb, partially obscuring the camera lens. Yeah, it's so good. I am so pleased with it. Look how close I got to this seagull. I'm glad it's actually working this stream. I think I had the wrong calibration mode on in the first time I streamed, but now it's lost to time, so no one will ever see the fact that I had my eyes closed for the whole stream. Oh, look at Min! Oh my gosh. That's pretty close. I want to see the seagull. Talk to Min. Min has a textbook in her lap. She's flipping it to a chapter review page. Oh, she's actually studying. Are you doing your homework? That's weirdly studious of you. I don't need to close my eyes to scry anymore. I've leveled up. I can do it with my eyes open. I told my parents I joined a tutoring club. Oh, she just said lol out loud. Funny, so did I. What? What do you need tutoring for? I told them I was the tutor. Oh, they're gonna like have a collaborative lie now. They're gonna pretend Noelle's tutoring Min. I know you say lol out loud. That's perfect. You can tutor Min then. Hey, that's what I said. Match made in heaven. Match made in hell? I don't want her help. As she says it, though, she's staring down at the page with a desolate expression. Math should just die. Why? It's a discipline full of beautiful and complex patterns. I have to agree. I'm not great at math, but it is, like, super cool when you think about it. There's nothing inherently bad or oppressive about it, but people treat it like it's evil and malicious. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna read all the messages. I always backread everything that I don't see. When the stream ends, I will see whatever the hell you're talking about. A lot of pure math lacks any kind of practical application and merely exists for the sake of stimulating people's minds and pushing the limits of the medium as far as possible. It's much like a form of art. Can't relate. Shut the fuck up. Dude, let me see it. I'll help you. Problem one. Bill can paint a house in 5 hours, and Mary can paint a house in 3 hours. How long will it take them to paint a house together? TV show AU Butterfly Soup? Oh, I thought you meant read TV show AU. Okay. No. I mean, I don't care that much. I mean, if you, and there's only so many characters, you know? Whatever. 8 hours. Come on, Min. She looks so pr she's so confident about it. Are you gonna be okay at the school? I've already talked to everyone. Let's talk to Noelle again. Well, peels a banana and takes a bite out of it. Can assign yourself, motherfucker. It's not my job. You're playing the game as much as well. You're not playing the game. I mean, like, you're experiencing the game. It's not. What the hell are you doing? Oh, I'm dying in real life. I don't know what just happened. Are you taking the banana sticker off? Why would I? It comes off with a peel anyway. Okay, well. Yeah, sorry. The wizard is dying live on stream. taking this... There's a rival wizard casting evil spells on me to zap my power. What's it called? Siphon. That's what I was trying to say. Taking the sticker off first would be completely pointless. So you just eat it with the sticker still on? Bug, hate Deltarune. Oh, turn your curse machine off. I'm trying to stream. No, I can't wizard duel that person yet. I need to train for 20 episodes. If you don't turn your curse machine off, I'm going to cast a spell that explodes it. It doesn't have any effect on the inside of the banana. The fuck's wrong with you? You're not human. How am I not human? Oh, I can't talk to Noelle anymore. Would you kiss a girl for $1 million? She'd do it for free. I guess. I don't have that kind of money, though. Oh, she thinks Akarsha meant, would you pay me $1 million for the chance to kiss a girl? What? No, I'm saying you get paid. Huh? Min would pay $1 million to kiss a girl. Oh, talk to Dia. Life is simply unfair. Any words of wisdom, Dia? Snowflakes are actually really, really small. Not like you would think from Christmas decoration. Oh, come on. How big did you think they were? Oh, they live in California. They've never seen snow. Like the size of a plate? Wow, he must have been crazy disappointed when you discovered the truth. Any other advice? You can make Nutella sandwiches and eat them. That's good advice. If you do this 3 times a day, you'll have 3 meals for like $150. Not $150, I can't read. I mean, I read it correctly, I just didn't say it right. $1.50. Thanks. The locker room door creaks open. When Noel sees Chris and Liz come through, she lifts her hand to wave, but aborts halfway through the motion. Aww. Scowling, she jerks the offending appendage back down like her hand had gone and betrayed the rest of her body. What? Nothing. Hey guys, we have a few announcements to make. The economy is in shambles. First of all, Minso, you need to resubmit your parental permission form for the club. And this time, please have a real parental guardian sign it. Get someone else to I bet Akarsha would, like, gladly forge a signature for her. I feel like that's something she could do. I don't know what you're talking about. She forged it? How can you tell? I bet it's, like, super clearly fake. She doesn't seem... Not to be mean, but she doesn't seem bright enough to do a convincing forgery. The signature was the word mom in cursive. Gotta love her. You love to see it. Fuck. Mid is running away. Krista gets up and chases after her. There's nowhere to run. You dumb kid. It sounds an awful lot like Min ran into the door again. Everyone else's forms look fine, though. Oh, Noelle did a good forgery then. So, good job, guys. If you forged it too, I couldn't tell. Noelle did. Oh, so did Akarsha. And probably Dia, too. Krista has returned, dragging a defeated Min behind her. Next up, we're playing against an actual team today. Oh, I forgot about her. What? Who? We invited the team at Niles over. Oh, wait, that's the school that Jinso goes to. They should be here soon. Are we going to be okay? Our team is made up of 4 baseball players, 2 nerds, and 3 weebs. I think it's 4 weebs. Did you count me as a nerd? I'm a hybrid. I'm a weeb too. Guys, we'll be fine. Maybe. The maybe was too honest. It's fine. Fucking Min and Dio will destroy it. Don't worry, it's seriously super casual. They aren't bringing their coaches or anything. It's just 9 of them driving over in their cars. Just relax and have fun. This isn't really important, but they have a cool mascot. It's Killer Whales. Last time I streamed, I was like, man, I should have gotten some water before I, started streaming. And then I didn't do it again this time. Because I, what was I saying? Head completely empty. What's our team name? Do we get a mascot too? Min, it says so right there. Come on. Read your damn shirt, it's a monarch. That's so bland. No, it's not. It's cool. Liquid. But we're not really an official school team, so we can make up a name ourselves. Ooh. Any suggestions? Do we get to choose? Bagels. The way you think is so damn cute. Look at her. She has it down so bad. Those two are the sweetest. Chicken nuggets? Bagels is so simple, I kind of like it. Yeah, I'd honestly be okay if it ended up like that. Any other suggestions? We should be something stronger than killer whales to assert our dominance. Monarch's already more powerful than killer whales, though. Not true. I think an orca whale can and will kill the Queen of England. Humans keep killer whales in captivity. But if it was like 1v1, a killer whale would tear a guy to shreds. We should be something bigger and more dangerous. Like what? Global warming? Oh my god, that's actually a hilarious name. No matter who we're up against, they'll pretty much automatically lose. Like, tigers versus global warming. Who do you think's gonna win? Our motto can be, underestimate us and the world will be destroyed. That's not a very positive motto. I'm still kind of impressed Noelle came up with that. What kind of name did you think I'd come up with? I don't know. Something nerdy that you thought sounded cool but was actually really cringy. Like the algorithms. Yuck. I feel like throwing up. Shut up, I never suggested that. And I don't like global warming, it's not threatening enough.
What the hell?
One sec. Okay. How is it not threatening enough? It's irreversible and will devastate generations to come. But it's not a thing, like a... Min, come on. Are you saying you don't believe in global warming? She means it's like an abstract concept. Yeah. We should be something that sounds like it could rip our enemies from limb from limb. Sorry, I was having curses and spells cast on me. Like Death Machine. Are we forming a heavy metal band? Death Bagels. That's better, I think. Death Bagels is dramatically cuter, but Min is too pleased that Dia combined their suggestions to complain. Wait, I just thought of a name too. No. What is that? In Yaoi, the Seme is the dominant guy in the couple. What is Yaoi? You don't want to know. Usually only teen girls who like anime know what it means, so maybe that's good. Most normal people will be totally oblivious. We got any teen girls who like anime in chat? Yeah, the only reason Noelle knows is because I corrupted her. Let me reiterate that this is a bad idea. We're going to have to make up a fake definition when our parents ask what it means. Your parents not gonna know. Yeah. Quiet down, small man. How was that worth it?
Okay, we'll settle this the fair way. Do you know what a majority vote is?
Everyone write your vote down on a piece of paper. Akasha votes for? Do you think our choices have consequences? I like global warming. I think it's funny. The winner is global warming. I love to vote for global warming. I guess the one downside is we only sound threatening to people who believe in it. That's fine. Even if they're too ignorant to accept scientific fact, that doesn't erase the reality that we're all not... Do you guys hear that? That doesn't erase the reality that we'll annihilate them. Big words for someone who couldn't catch a ball if it had Elmer's glue on it. You shut up. Alright, guys, be nice. The global warming. Head out to the field. The other team is on their way. They're parking right now. Let's stretch and warm up first. They arrange in a huge circle and begin stretching like usual. Focus on your breathing and calm your mind. Suddenly, Noelle whirls around looking frantic. Noelle, get with the program. Be a Zen master. Where's Dia? Huh? She didn't follow us out? Indeed, Dia is nowhere in sight. Holy shit, she's so quiet I didn't even notice she was gone. Minso is missing too. Oh my god. They're doing it. That's impossible. Min told me she was going to the bathroom on the way out, but that was like 15 minutes ago. She should be back by now. Maybe they got left behind in the locker room. What? Nothing. I was just randomly screaming. Looks like Dee and Min aren't here. And the girls' bathroom is empty. We should split up and search for them. No, I've watched enough TV to know where this is going. We'll get picked off one by one. I didn't realize that's what she meant. What is this, a horror movie? Hell yeah, dude. The killer whales will be here any minute. We don't have time to comb the school slowly together. Besides, we already lost the main problem, children. The rest of them aren't the type to just randomly wander off like this. I mean, Dia's not a problem, child. That's true. I think Akasha would. Disperse global warming. Meet back at the field in 10 minutes, whether you find them or not. Don't know why I read the line like that. Roger that. Noelle is holding the door open for people as they exit the locker room. She smiles. She smiles as Akasha comes closer. I can't stand here all day. You're cut off. Noelle lets the door close in Akasha's face. Oh my god. Noelle is waiting for Akasha outside. Meanie. Where should we look? I don't know. If it was just Dia, I'd have guesses, but it's likely Minso forced her to go somewhere. You realize Dia is like a foot taller and 100 pounds heavier than Min, right? Min can't force Dia to do anything. If she took her somewhere, it's because Dia let her. Fine, forced was too strong of a word. Coerced. Dude, chill. You're so neurotic when it comes to Dia. Can't you just trust in her judgment? In kindergarten, I asked Dia what she wanted to be when she grew up, and she said a police dog. Well, it was kindergarten. Even in kindergarten, I understood that becoming another species wasn't an option. When I was a kid, I said that when I grew up, I wanted to be a bluebird. Oh, we can point and click now. Search the bathroom. Why is it called a restroom? I am fighting for my life in here! I thought Min might be having a diarrhea catastrophe or something. Are you trying to make me throw up? I like that they're searching together. Yeah, it's my hobby. This is just like Over the Garden Wall. You know, sometimes I wonder why I bother with you. Because you love me. No, I don't. Yes, you do. No, I don't. Yes, you do. This is stupid. Knock it off. You didn't deny it that time. Confirmed. Not confirmed. That's not how it works. Let's see. Search the courtyard. Search the locker room. Let's search the locker room again, even though we were just in there. Hey, that's... Oh, we found her! She's running around to burn off her gay energy. Dia's sprinting around the track at top speed. Yo, Dia! She can't hear us from here. Once Dia runs a bend, and Noelle and Akasha flag her down. She's completely drenched in sweat. What are you doing? I got nervous, so I ran 3 miles. Feel better now. I was right. Okay. Why didn't you say anything? Tia looks at her as though she's crazy. I really like this face. Stressful. I don't like to bother people. Dude, you know that not communicating just makes most situations more stressful, right? Where's Min? Huh? What do you mean? I guess you went missing separately. Never mind, just go back to the diamond then. That way Chris and Liz will know where you are. Dia nods and trots off. Ba-ba-ba. Oh my god, I don't believe it. What? This is a bush! No. I never would have guessed. Okay, great, thanks. The poster says reduce stress. Haha, how exactly do they expect us to do that? Not go to school? Get rid of our parents? Go to classrooms? Go to locker room? Oh, wait. Biss and Big. Thanks, Harley. Give me a kiss for me, okay? Akasha admires her own reflection in the window. I hate myself, but in a fun way where I'll still check myself out. Where are we going? Auditorium? Oh, courtyard. Okay. It's dead quiet in here. If I farted, you could hear it from a mile away. Please don't yell something. Oh, she made a murp? Karsha's shrieking echoes in the empty hall for several seconds. Wow, the acoustics in here are great. I realize there's nothing I can do to prevent you from doing this, so I'll wait outside and pretend not to know you. Noelle leaves the auditorium. Sasuke! Stressed out. Stop asking about college. I'm not gonna beatbox for you guys. Stop asking about majors in my career. Stop asking about my future. I don't know. I don't know. I'm not good at anything. Aw. I'm a fraud. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm not that smart. I'm so afraid of failure that everything I do has to be funny. Because if I'm not serious, it's not like I was really trying. I'm not beatboxing for you. Good thing I disguise it as a series of jokes so no one notices the gaping chasm of darkness I live on the edge of. What are you doing? Why are you here? Weren't you supposed to be going to the bathroom?
I was. There's a family bathroom over there.
Aww.
She points to the door at the far end of the auditorium.
Okay.
Anyone can use it. It doesn't matter whether you're a boy or a girl.
Gender?
Right.
Min looks relieved that Akarsha let the topic drop.
Were you serious about that dying stuff?
Nah, man, I'd never actively try to off myself.
It's more like if I was crossing the street and a car came barreling towards me, I'm not sure I'd get out of the way. We got gender up in here.
Then I'll hit the car out of the way.
You're gonna... You'll hit it with what?
With my own car. I'll ram into the one driving towards you.
Yeah, I'm gonna fucking pop my testosterone bottles like shots. Oh shit, that's like a pun. I didn't do that on purpose. Your car will get crushed.
No, it won't. My car will be stronger.
You think I'm gonna own some weak, shrimpy-ass car?
That other car is as good as dead.
She's so funny. She's serious. She dead-ass tried to save me by crashing into another car.
Min looks relieved that she made Akarsha laugh.
Aww.
She's holding an emo Linkin Park skateboard under one arm.
Wanna learn how to skateboard?
Those aren't allowed at school, you know.
We're supposed to be doing baseball practice.
Rules are made to be broken.
Are you a square or a triangle?
I'm pretty sure that's not how the saying goes.
Min places her skateboard on the floor.
Here, I'll show you something cool.
Do a kickflip.
Hold on to me.
Is this the Titanic song? What's it called? My Heart Will Go On?
Yeah, there we go.
Oh, I'm gonna get copyright claimed.
But don't make this weird. Don't make this weird. What did I just say, you useless hoe?
Oh, this fucking rules. What the hell? Min manages to stand on the skateboard with a crouch on her shoulders.
We're soaring. Flying.
Something, something. Breaking free.
I haven't watched High School Musical. I don't know the rest of the lyrics. I'm immune to audio?
I think, yeah, I bet the recorder will save me.
It's okay, just keep repeating that one line.
We're soaring, flying.
Hell yeah, dude. Feel better now?
Yeah, I'm fine. I needed that.
Aw, Carsha's eyes are filling up with tears.
Friendship is real.
You know what the economy needs?
$3 bills. They should put my face on it.
I agree.
I got a $2 bill at work the other day, and it was the most exciting thing that's ever happened to me.
Oh, Min ribs are in the arm?
You suck.
Mean?
Akarsha ribs back.
Hey!
Whoops, that was a bit harder than I expected.
I love violence.
My punches inflict poison damage now.
Turned into a fist fight.
Come on. Hearing the signs of violence, Noelle has run back into the auditorium. She heard a fist fight, but not Akarsha, like, yelling about her depression.
Krissa, look what they're doing. Min, come back to the field with me.
Krissa drags Min off, leaving Akarsha and Noelle behind.
You found both of them.
Yes.
Once again, I'm a hero.
You're not a hero.
Let's head back to the field, too.
Bad memories looking at this now. I was an idiot.
No, you weren't. That plan ruled.
She's gonna say I told you so.
If you're waiting for me to disagree, we're going to be here all day.
Akasha goes into the family bathroom. Unlike the regular ones, there's only one stall.
It's so clean.
Where's the pee on the toilet seat? Where's the poo and blood stains like in the girls' bathroom?
It must be this pristine because no one else knows about it.
This is heaven. No wonder Min uses it.
Not me. It's you.
Fascinating. Let's keep staring at this instead of doing something more useful. Fuck you.
Finally, everyone's here. I'm going to take this. I feel like this is an appropriate place for me to go like fill up a cup of water. I'll be right back.
Maybe now that I have water, I'll stop feeling so physically wretched. Oh, did you guys not have music? I thought you could still hear the, like, game. I'm back. Let's make sure everything works. I seem to still be functioning. Hold on. Let's make sure. I want everything to run smoothly. Still calibrated. Hello, gamers. And no one fell victim to a serial killer. What a relief. Global warming assemble. The other team is warming up on the field. One sec. I'm getting cold again. There's always some sort of fucking temperature in my room.
I took off my shirt earlier because I was too warm. Two of them break from the rest of the group and rush up to Dia.
Dia rears back in fear and hides behind Noelle for a moment before she appears to recognize them. Oh, it's the guys from before. Dia, it's us. I don't even know this guy's name. We never learned it. Oh! Dia high-fives them with a brutally excessive amount of force. Their palms meet with a deafening clap. The victim swears and flaps the affected hand as if to shake off the stinging. He's trying valiantly to smile, but there are tears of pain in his eyes. I love violence. Yay, Jinso! I don't know why I'm so excited to see him. He hasn't really had any, like, character moments yet. I just like recognizing people. We made our team accept the match when we heard you were here. You look different from Min now. I can't believe it. Wouldn't it be more unbelievable if we still looked the same after all this time? He raises her hand for another high five. No, I don't want it. Dia, you know them? We know Hayden from elementary school, and June's my twin. Hayden? June jolts at the sound of Min's voice, visibly shocked. Min? What are you doing here? Same thing as you. Baseball. Do Mom and Dad know you're doing this? Do you even need to ask? Jin sighs. He seems really used to this. Now that everyone's here, let's get started. Since we're the home team, we're defending first. Liz hands Min what looks like a tiny white pouch filled with powder. Oh, it's chalk. For a second I was like, my god, it's cocaine. A cloud of dust puffs out when she grabs it. You have rosin to improve your grip. That's like... real rosin. Min is so excited that she accidentally inhales a bunch of the powder. I think Min eats chalk as well. Yeah, she does truly have Susie vibes. I'm constructing kin lists for all of these characters, and Susie's on Min's. That's not true, I'm not doing that. Hayden is the leadoff hitter. Go, white boy, go! Min spits on the ground for dramatic effect. Ew. Min, that's gross. Don't do that again. Dia crouches into position. As an afterthought, she points her index finger down at the ground. Min smugly nods and straightens back up on the mound. When's the kinless construction stream? I don't know. I'll need to make time for it. I'm busy. Since when do you two have signs? Oh, they don't mean anything. We're just doing it because it looks cool. You'll get a tier list stream whenever the fuck I feel like doing it. You're in my ball court, baby. Sports. Min winds up and throws. The ball comes in chest high, perfectly spinless. If someone had written a message on it, you could read it. Then it does what looks like a double dip and drops into Dia's glove. Hayden swings at it, but he's way off. Yeah. Let's go Mets, baby, love the Mets. Was the scream really necessary? Hayden manages to skim the next pitch. It bounces up about an inch above the bat and plops down in front of the plate. Dia pounces on it and throws him out. No, what was that? A knuckleball. It's like a trick pitch. Get a home run, baby, love the Mets. I don't trust it. Cursed. She's casting spells out here in the ball game field. It's not cursed. It's like that because of physics. Cursed. Kessa yells out to Global Warming triumphantly. See, I told you I wasn't making it up. Sakura and Yuki exchange a look, then turn to Krista with skeptical faces. Min is a ball game. Come on. The next batter swings helplessly at three knucklers and sits down.
Jinso is up against his twin now. Min winds up and lets another knuckler go. He hit a line dive straight at Akasha. Oh, he's practiced with her, so he knows how to hit him. It's coming toward me. I can't reach it with my hand. Kick it. Let's go. Soccer. Akasha kicked the ball. She's now hopping around on one foot in pain. Ow, ow. You fucking dumbass. Why didn't you just catch it? Don't mind. What? Don't mind. They say that in sports anime when someone screws up. Do they? I've never watched a sports anime. That's not true. I've watched Yuri on Ice. I'm literally gonna throw up. You even said it with a fake Japanese accent. Oh, I didn't know that. Wait, I think it's a good idea, though. It helps boost morale. I don't even know what that would sound like with a Japanese accent, because I don't watch sports anime. The ball bounces back toward home plate. Forgot how to read. Dia scoops up the ball and hurls it to first. Out. We got an umpire up in here? What the? That actually worked. I'm a certified genius. Albert Einstein, my Nobel Prize. You're not getting a Nobel Prize for kicking a ball instead of catching it right away. Aw, don't we have real dugouts? There's just a little bench on each side. That's just what, like, school baseball fields are like. What were you expecting? The school doesn't have an official baseball team, so we're lucky to even have this. I never got why dugouts needed to be half underground like that. Because it's cool. Like, it's not a freaking bomb shelter. Stop being so dramatic. You've been to what so much? Baseball? What were we talking about? Oh, that's what they're like. I misread your message. That is just what school baseball is like. There's not quite enough space for everyone. It's fine, Min can sit on Dia's lap. Left standing, Dia hovers uncertainly behind them. There's not enough room. Then you can sit in my lap. That's what I said. I think I might have said it the other way around, but that was, like, on accident. You'd crush her. Shouldn't it be the other way around? Why the hell would it be the other way around? You're the smaller one? Ow! Get fucked. Min kicked Akasha really hard under the bench. Dia and Noelle both startled at Akasha's yelp. Neither of them saw the kick. Huh? What's wrong with you? Yeah, violence. She's glaring at me with a murderous look in her eyes. I farted. I'm adding Min to Maldwin's kin list. I was trying to cover up the sound. What? Crap, I don't think she buys it. That's inconsistent with your past behavior. Last week you told me the disgusting and unwanted fact that you had 3 consecutive farts that formed a D major triad. Why go through such lengths to mask a single fart now? I don't think Akasha does anything for any reason. You're hiding something. I should scream now as a distraction. Shut up! Stop screaming! I'm not taking Maldwin's white ass to IKEA. You're screaming too. Oh, she actually did it! The bench creaks a bit as Tia nervously lowers herself in Min's lap. Min immediately wraps an arm around Tia's waist. I have to do this so we don't lose our balance. Yeah! Better watch out, Tia. Min's probably thinking about doing bad things to you. I'm gonna do bad things to you, Akasha. Really? Like what? Like, snap your fucking neck. How mean. Jinso is pitching against global warming. I can't, fuck, We're fucking stuck with global warming now, because I thought it was funny. His throws look a lot faster than Min's. And then what? He strikes Esther out with ease. Out. Who's the fucking umpire? We're not even a real baseball team. Did they bring one with them? Liz is keeping score with a pencil and paper. She dutifully marks the strikeout with a K. Why isn't a strikeout S or S-O? Why K? I was gonna ask the same question. K is for killed. That can't be it. It's because S is already used for there are sacrifices in baseball? The K is from the last letter of struck. That's a lame reason. Agreed. I like Min's reason better. Sakura is up to bat now. She whiffs the first pitch, but pops the second one up. I got it. He chases the ball into foul territory and dives for it. Out. This situation sucks. Even if we were able to get first base, we could steal or do some weird shit, but no. Actually, I did some research on that. In most cases, attempting to steal has a much higher chance of having a negative result than a positive one. Since most of us aren't that confident in our stealing skills, it would be better for us not to try it. What the hell are you saying? Stealing's important. No, it objectively has little value and is often actually detrimental. For steal attempts to not be detrimental, you have to succeed around 70% of the time. That's the point where you break even. Simply succeed 70% of the time, then. The exact number depends on the situation, but it's always around that range. For instance, if a runner on first with no outs getting caught stealing will lose a team 2/3 of a run on average, and successful steal gains 1/3 of a run. So for every 3 steal attempts, you need to convert at least 2, or the only thing you're stealing is runs from your team. Do you succeed that often? If not, you're actually hurting the team's chances. It looks like she understood none of that. Shut your hell up, you lamppost. Shut your hell up. Lamppost? You can't reduce things down to numbers. Yes, I can. She uses a stick to scratch a formula into the dirt. SBP equals SB. SB plus CX times 100%. Min quickly stomps out the formula. The evil is defeated. Those equations are just a bunch of word games. They're not real. Look, this is even a matter of opinion. I'm right. Numbers don't lie. There are things you can't see. Like what? Your feelings? The power of friendship? Does it not occur to you that perhaps your enemies have those things too? They're on both sides of the equation, so they cancel each other out. Oh my god, this is baseball, not rocket science. But this isn't rocket science. This is basic algebra. Bro, give it up. Noelle hates being wrong. Actually, I wouldn't know. I'm not familiar with the sensation. Liz comes up and taps Akarsha on the shoulder. Hey, you're up to bat now. Akarsha lets out a prolonged croaking sound that lasts for 30 seconds. Check this shit out. That was a spell. I'm just playing the character. We're down 2 outs, so I better not screw this up. Akarsha picks a bat and heads to the plate. Use psychological warfare. You're not invited to my birthday party anymore. What? This is my special technique, verbal smoke bomb. My remark brought up so many questions that he's been thrown into confusion. Street smarts. Akarsha, cut it out. Still looking perplexed, Jinso pitches the ball. Akarsha isn't experienced enough to distinguish balls from strikes, so she randomly decides whether or not to swing.
Unsurprisingly, she racks up 3 strikes in an instant. No, my special technique! How about you practice more instead of using your special technique? It's time to switch sides now. Oh, okay, good night. Sorry for casting spells of Terper on you. Sweet dreams. The batter hits the ball towards Akarsha again. Akarsha fumbles the ball, allowing the runner to safely reach the bag. Oh, they've got sandbags instead of bases. Thanks for screwing up. I didn't screw up. That was on purpose. The truth is, I'm a double agent. Just admit you messed up already. The killer whales have one out and a runner on first. The runner takes off as Jinso bunts the ball. It rolls slowly all the way down the left foul line. Dia follows it closely, hovering over it like a hawk. What's she doing? If Dia can grab it when it's on the left side of the line, it'll count as foul. You can't run on foul balls, so the runner will have to return to first. The ball is still rolling almost exactly down the line. Akarsha runs ahead of the ball and drags her foot into the dirt to make a path curving to the right. Hey! The ball hits the path and rolls foul. Dia quickly grabs it. I'm a triple agent. You can't just change allegiances to match whenever you're not, you messed up. Minther's the next pitch for a strike. Nice work. Time to switch sides again. That was fast. That's what I thought. It's good. It means Min's knuckleball is working. We should give it a special name. Like, Knuckles. I'm not calling it a damn Sonic character. It can be butterfly related since they flutter. Butterfly thingy. Miles tells Edgeworth. Butterfly from Hell's Anus. The anus part wasn't necessary. Noelle, you're up to bat. Uh-oh. Akarsha catcalls Noelle as she walks up to the plate. Whoa, it's Noelle! Zooey mama! Shut up. How mean. A swing and a miss. I wonder if Noelle enjoys this? She's having fun. She's scowling as she swings the bat. That's just her personality. If she disliked it, she would quit by now. Noelle strikes out. Dia, you're next. Catcher gets up and stands far off to the side, away from Dia. Jin throws it into his mitt. It's an intentional walk. Right off the bat, they haven't even seen her hit yet. I zoned out. Is Dia up to bat? They're scared of her. Hayden knows how strong she is from when we were little. They probably figure it's fine to let her have first since no one else on the team can get a hit. That's smart. It'll be hard for us to score without her. Once I've thrown 4 balls, Dia throws the bat to the side and trots to first. It looks like he made the right call because after Dia's walk, the team accumulates 2 more outs in an instant. Dia's stranded there until they switch sides. Neither team manages to score for the next few innings. Dia's getting walked at each bat. And the others aren't skilled enough to reliably hit the enemy's pitches. A few people managed to get hits off Min's knuckleball by chance, but no one's made it home yet. By the 7th inning, some of Min's luck starts to run out. Min's next pitch comes high and inside, but instead of dropping, it soars up into the air. Dia has to jump to catch it. That's the 4th ball. The batter throws his bat aside and jogs to the first base. The bases are loaded with no outs. This is terrible. They're probably going to score at least 1 goal. Did you just say goal? The next batter is a buff-looking fellow. Can I see him? He smashes the pitch straight into right field, where Noelle is. No, that's the worst possible person he could have hit it to. It's so far out that the ball is like a speck in the clouds. Noelle is apprehensively backing up with her glove out, squinting up at the sky. She plants her feet firmly shoulders width apart, reaches up, and claps her free hand decisively over the glove. She caught it! She caught it! Aw. I bet she's been doing research. How is that possible? The runners all skid and scramble to reverse direction. They all need to tag up on their former bases or now they're out. No one thought she would catch it. Here's her chance. Noelle throws to Liz at second base. There's a loud slap noise as Liz covers her glove with her hand, preventing the ball from bouncing out. She easily tags the bag before Hayden can return to it. That's two outs. Just one more. Liz rears up and throws to Akarsha, who's manning first base. What the hell? There's nothing in Liz's hand. She's throwing nothing at Akarsha. Akarsha pretends to... They're cheating! Noelle didn't actually catch it, huh? I love lying. Akarsha pretends to catch it in her glove and tags first base before June reaches it. Out. The runners are dejectedly returning to their defensive positions. A triple play. June is looking at Akarsha suspiciously. Wait a minute, she's not holding anything. He saw... What? Where's the ball, then? Heck if I know. How do you guys not know? I got it. Kizza plucks the missing ball from the grass in right field where it's been the entire time. Noelle didn't even catch it in the first place. I knew it! So we're not out after all. No, you're all still out. The rulebook states that if a runner abandons his effort to run the bases, he's out. She's engaging in psychological warfare. You all clearly gave up. So it's still a triple play. You son of a bitch! Hey! That was actually a compliment, I think. It was a compliment. This kind of feels like an asshole move, though. I think it's fun. What planet do you guys live on where Noelle isn't an asshole? Is it okay to trick them like that? Isn't it cheating? It's not cheating. You guys deserve a freaking Academy Award for that performance just now. Especially Noelle. Good job. Shut up. Don't praise me like I'm a little kid. Are you crying? Oh, I'm not crying. By the way, when you act like the ball is somewhere it's not, that's called a deke, short for decoy. Deeks are an important part of the infield play, like a feint. They're really as elaborate as a three-way deke we just pulled right now, but it's the same idea. I didn't know that was allowed. We the deke squad. Get it? Oh my god, it's like a dick squad, but deke. Deke squad. Deke squad. Deke squad. Deke squad. I bet the teachers always separate you two in class. You bring out the worst in each other. It's Akarsha's turn to bat again. There's already two outs and no one on base. The game's still tied. 0-0. 00. Just like suddenly, June cries out for the mound. Oh, wait, time out. My contact hurts. Everyone pauses. What's wrong with it? I think I got dust under the lens. Face screwed up in pain, he checks out what appears to be a tiny plunger. Huh? What is that? It's for taking out contact lens. Just do it with your finger. You're gonna play without it on? You can't pitch like that. Hayden, didn't you say you wanted to try pitching? Right now? I've literally never pitched a ball in my life. Why not? There's our first time for everything. Jinso takes out the offending contact. He's now effectively blind in one eye. Oh, bad vision. Okay, here goes nothing. Intimidate him. I go to baseball games. I eat the baseballs. Hayden pitches the ball. Akarsha gets up just in time to take a wild swing at it. I somehow hit it. Through sheer luck, it's heading towards June, who's squinting up at it with his good eye. I got it. Whew, the ball hits him in the face. Get some depth perception next time. Carson makes it to second base in confusion. I think when this baseball game ends, I'll quit. Nice batting. Finally, for the first time this entire game, someone's on base when Dia's up. Even though Hayden is just walking Dia, he looks really scared to be pitching against her. I'm hoping I can start doing like 2 streams a week. Because I feel like a week is too long to wait between things. And it's like, I want to play more than one game at a time without just like doing the same thing on end for weeks. But that feels less doable when it's like a week between streams. But I think I have more flexibility now because we're being less swamped staffing wise. He throws the next pitch. Everyone watches the ball soar straight up into the sky in a high arc. Drops back down about halfway to the plate. He did it, Noel. Don't name errors after me. Hayden, what are you doing? Shut up, it slipped out of my hand. Hayden picks the ball up and tries again. He accidentally throws it straight at Chica's head. Dia ducks. Ah, sorry. What the fuck is your problem? How dare you? Dia could have been killed. They're all defending her. Min and Noelle have stormed out to the mound and are bashing Hayden together. I love them. I'm calling the police. What? No one got hurt. That doesn't matter. It was criminal negligence. I will personally make sure your entire life is ruined. He should be executed. Yes, kill. Executed? Hey, get back on the bench. Noelle, put the phone down. No one's getting arrested. Min, where did you get more knives? Ah, lover. I think every time Min has a knife, it duplicates. Never-ending exponential knives. Gonna gut you like a fish on the pitcher's mat. That's not what it's called. What's it called? The mound. There we go. I knew it started with M. Yeah, that was the joke I was making. Thank you, Harley. I think it's just like me and you in here. I think there are some people who are like, watching quietly. I think Pastel fell asleep, though. So, in terms of people who are participating, it's just the besties. Dia steps back up to the place as Min and Noelle are dragged back to the bench. They're both glowering at the corner, darkly muttering to one another. Your phone restarted? Oh, I genuinely thought you were asleep. I wouldn't put it past you. There is no justice in the world. Both of you, knock it off. You're one of the besties. I just meant like one-on-one. Oh, I missed dialogue. Hey, where'd I go? Hayden winds up and throws the ball. You're one of the... It's not far enough outside. You lunged out at it and made contact. She got a hit off the intentional walk attempt. She hammers it straight into right field at Jinso again. I got this. I got this. The ball rolls through his legs. Diana Karsha cross home plate to win the game! Yeah! I can't believe it, we won! You don't have to look so blatantly shocked. The Niles team is departing. Min and Noelle glare at Hayden as he goes into the van they arrived in. They're so funny. Are you guys still plotting revenge? I'll help, I love drama. Are you still on your period? Maybe you can touch him with your cursed period blood hand again. I forgot she did that. Too late, man. The blood's brown now. They might think it's mud. Ew. There's 9 of us, though. So there's probably 2.25 other girls on the team. A fourth of a girl? What if we got all of them to run at the boys' team from different directions? That'd be like a nightmare. I doubt anyone would agree to that plan. Honestly, the guys would probably freak out even if you just threw a clean pad at them. Oh my gosh, you're right. Thanks for the idea. No, no. Don't do this. I refuse to be involved in this. I'm casting spell of fraction your gender. This is friendship goals, Frenchman. If we go down, we all go down together. That's just a roundabout way of saying you're dragging me down with you. Akarsha pulls a pad from her backpack and rips the wrapper open with a loud crinkle. I don't get why they make the sound so conspicuous. Yeah, it's kind of fucked up. I know, right? The only way they could make it more obvious is if they added firecrackers. Krissa is power walking over to them. She has developed a sixth sense when some stupid shit is about to go down. Who's opening a pad out here? Noelle quickly moves about 15 feet away and pretends not to know them. We gotta make this quick. We should soak it with something to make it more unknown. I have Gatorade. What flavor? Yellow one. Yellow flavor. Oh, piss, piss, piss. Yes. I hate that I know you well enough to discern that you want it to look like pee. Are you listening to us from all the way over there? Pee girl. Akarsha pours a splash of the Gatorade on it. I feel like I'm doing one of those absorbency demonstrations in commercials. Our liquid is the wrong color, though. It's always blue. Those cowards. They should use red like blood. Akarsha holds up the finished creation. I'm gonna throw it now. Should I? No. Do it! Akarsha flings the pad like a frisbee into the van. It hits Jinso in the shoulder. What is that? Jin goes down. Screams fill the van as a grenade was thrown in. I nearly said Gatorade instead of grenade. It's the same thing, if you think about it. The team desperately scatters away from the deadly object. Someone is climbing out the window. What did you brats do this time? Run. Run! Get back here. Oh, Dia's house. Hey, I'm here. Hello, Dia, homie. They put me back in the time loop. Dia's examining something on a tree branch. Miles tells Edgeworth made a cocoon. She points at the chrysalis. He's soup now inside. Oh shit, that's the name of the game! Isn't it crazy? Their whole body liquefies and has to rebuild itself. I wish I could do that. They put me back in the time loop. Imagine if growing up was that bad for us. It must be a complicated process. I always worry something will go wrong and they won't ever wake up. What if someone shakes it really hard? It'll stir the soup. Nah, man, they're pretty resilient. Did you know its memory survives that? If you teach a caterpillar something, like to fear a certain smell or whatever, it comes out of its cocoon as a butterfly, it'll still remember. That doesn't sound true. Pastel, are you there? Is that true? Even though the outside's different, it's still the same caterpillar on the inside, from beginning to end. I don't think that's true. I feel like I don't, think of insects as having complicated memory. Will he remember me? Sure, as much as an eating machine can. egg transgender-wise. Believe in Miles Tales Edgeworth. Akarsha. Oh, wait, I forgot that I said I was gonna quit after the baseball game. Whatever. Yeah? I need to tell you something. Noelle wouldn't understand. I... lesbian. I like a girl. Oh, nice. You're not surprised. I mean, I can tell. I'm bi. Huh? It's not a secret? I've literally hit on girls in front of you. I've literally hit on you? You what? But those were all jokes. I thought you were kidding. The kinds of jokes you decide to tell are indicative of your character. Of course she's bi, I'm not surprised. I tell gay jokes because I am a gay joke. Also, you should tell Min. She likes you back. I'll help you. Oh, we're switching characters. Yes, Min time. Okay, I'm gonna save. This is a good stopping point. Let me save, please. Yes. Alright. Okay. Yeah, that's it.
I've been going for, a while.
I feel like this game is longer than I expected. I thought it would only be, like, a couple of hours long, but now I've done two several-hour-long streams. I guess it's longer because I'm, like, voice-acting the dialogue. So I guess I'll have to play it again, later, since I've already decided I'm, starting Night in the Woods next week. See you too. Bye-bye. I don't have an